Hello everyone, today we will discuss an example on addressing modes. So consider this example. Here they are telling that there is a two word instruction which is stored at location 200 and 201 in memory. Okay, they have given some value to program counter. It is now 200, a register with value of 400 and an index register with value of 100. Okay, so it is basically given in Morris Menu Book. This is memory, and this is the whole scenario that is given in question. Okay, so these are some locations, and this is given as data, and we have to calculate effective addresses and content of accumulator, that is operand, basically in each case. I mean in all type of addressing modes. Okay, so let's start. So first we have to calculate the value for direct addressing mode. So in direct addressing mode, we all know that the address field gives us effective address. So if we will execute this instruction, two word instruction, we are getting at first load to accumulator, then mode, and then there is address field here. Okay, so address field has value 500. So the effective address here will be 500. Okay, direct addressing mode, the effective address is the value given in address field. Now what will be the operand? Operand will be the value stored at memory location which is pointed by effective address. So here 500 is pointed by effective address, and the value here, that is 800, will be our operand. Okay, now second mode, indirect mode. What it tells? It tells that what value is given here as operand will be our effective address. Means the location of the operand is given as effective address. So we have we will go to address, okay, and the value given at the address will be our effective address in case of indirect mode. So effective address will be the value pointed by the value given in address field, that will be 800, and 800 when we fetch 800th location in memory, we will get 300 as operand. Okay, now immediate addressing mode, it tells that the value given in address field is basically our data, is our operand. Means address field is giving us 500. So 500 is our operand. So what will be the effective address? The address where it is stored. Means 500 is stored at 201. So our effective address will be 201 here. Okay. Now coming to the register. We haven't given any number to the register. So we can put it blank, and the value of register is the operand. So value of register, that is 400, this 400 is the operand. Now register indirect mode, it tells that value of register is our effective address. So value of register is 400, that will be our effective address, and we will go to this location at memory, in the memory. So 400th location as value 700. So 700 will be our operand here. Now coming to auto increment part. Auto increment part tells that first give me the data, then increment register by 1. So we will use basically register indirect mode here. Register indirect mode tells the value of register is my location. So value of register is its location, and the operand, what will be the operand? Operand will be the value stored at this place in memory, that is again 700. Okay, so after that this value will be incremented by 1. Okay, means now after execution of this instruction it will point to 401. Okay, so that will not affect both of the values. Now consider auto decrement. I am telling both independent of each other. I am not telling that we have applied auto increment then on same data I am applying the auto decrement. Means I am not telling that now it is incremented at 401, so we have to go to 401 and search for auto decrement. No, we are not doing that. I am going to simply auto decrement. What will happen if we will apply auto decrement on this scenario? So in auto decrement, first the value of register is decremented by 1. So here register value is 400. Okay, 400 will be decremented by 1, that will give me 399, and it will be our effective address. Now we will go to this address and fetch the data, that will be our operand. So 399 is giving me 450. 450 will be our operand. In case of relative, what relative tells? Relative addressing mode tells that program counter plus address field will give me effective address. So program counter plus address field. What is program counter value? I told that after execution of this instruction, the program counter will be incremented by 1. Means first program counter was at 200. It executed this part of instruction, then it is incremented by 1, then it executed this instruction. Okay, and instruction execution is now finished. Now it will point to next instruction, that is the work of program counter. So it will point to 202. Means program counter's value is now 202. So 202 plus address field has value 500. So this will be the value of our effective address, that is 702. And 702, when we fetch 702, we will get our data or operand as 325. Okay, so this is our operand in case of this relative address mode. Now we will go to index addressing mode. Index addressing mode tells that the value of index register will be added to the address field and it will give me effective address. So PC plus XR. Program counter value is, address field plus XR. So address field value is 500 plus 100, that is 100. Okay, so it will give me 600. Now we will go to 600th location in memory, and we will fetch the data, that is 900. So 900 will be our operand in this case. Okay, so in this way we will solve any questions given for addressing mode. Okay, thank you.